to OpenTX.
TaranisQX7. Here's a morph pattern. Clean with isopropyl. Do a quick job, nothing crazy. And you can use tweezers to remove from the decal sheet. The decal sheet is contoured cut. Place the decal down gently. Remove excess pieces off if you wish. Makes things easier to take off. Once you've removed all these pieces, you can start taking off pretty much any piece you want to put on. There is one big piece on here that's somewhat intimidating, but as long as you line up the switches, you should be good to go. As you can see in the video, I'm removing some of these dial cutouts and for the switches. So here's the big piece. This one's a little intimidating at first, but once you get it off, you don't have to pull it off hard. You just follow the contour and pull it off. And this piece is really big and intimidating, but it's actually not too bad to put on. You can just line up the screen, the two switches, and just let them rest. And it pretty much lines itself up. You can line up with the screen at the bottom. Use your fingers to work from the middle out if you can. In some cases, it just doesn't really matter. You can use your pick, the backside, to bring down corners that you might not be able to reach with your fingers. I'm not sure what I'm looking for. I think I was looking for a tool. might have to cut that piece out. Anyways, I'm basically telling you to watch out for, you can pretty much use anything. You can use a credit card. You can use the back of the pick, but just make sure that the pick isn't sharp. And don't scratch your radio up. This wrap will cover 95% of the radio. 5% is basically just those small little gaps that you might put the wrap on slightly crooked. You might say screw it. The wrap fits quite well, but there are some spots on there that they're just pretty impossible to get, so that's why I say at 95% coverage. From a foot away distance, you don't even see those sections. So anyways, as you put down the wrap, you can use your pick to guide some of the corners that are tight corners. Use the reliefs, use those as little guides to line you up with the radio. You can basically just use your thumb, help the decal get across. In some cases you might want to pull on it a little bit. You don't generally have to, unless you might have not gotten it on straight. If by chance you couldn't put on the big piece, or It sticks together for some reason. As long as you pull off gently, you won't have too much of a problem. Here we're lining the bottom piece. And the reason I did this such a big piece is because the radio comes with a weird texture on top where my right hand is. And the old decal material that I was using was not sticking on very well, and it was kind of curling up. So I had to find a different media that was way better, stronger. And I also felt that it was a lot cleaner if you were able to just bend over most of the sections, and it just gives it just a better look overall. No cutouts, no creases. So the difficulty level on this is pretty minimal as long as you get it off the sheet. And if you, like I said earlier, if you happen to get it stuck to itself, not a big deal. As long as you take your time to separate it, you're good to go. The decal takes 48 hours to fully cure, so in those 48 hours you can still use your radio. But just like I'm rubbing the radio down right now with my finger, if you happen to notice there's a section that's looks like it might not be down all the way, just rub it down with your finger and it should be good to go. After the 48 hours, you probably won't be seeing any lifting anywhere. With the heat gun, you'll be able to get a lot more of those stubborn corners to basically fold right over for you without any greaves. So the wrap right now, I'm basically just putting it on fairly light. I'm not doing anything really aggressive. I'm a little distracted there by the GoPro because it wasn't connecting. I did speed this up in a few sections. I was trying to cut down on the time of the wrap, so some places you'll see that it looks like I'm just warping into different sections. I'm trying to save as much time as possible but also be as helpful as possible. So as you can see, I'm taking my pick, and everything's pretty self-explanatory. The big piece was pretty much the hardest piece, and it doesn't take very long to put on. Now we're switching over to the bottom piece. I also made the wrap fit the bottom, and the reason I did that is because most of the times your wrap, or your radio, sorry, is sitting on its back, and the bottom is exposed. So I took the opportunity of also wrapping that as well. And this section here, I just slightly, like, sorry, not slightly. I lightly put it on. Use the back side of my pick. Use the front side too, in case I need to get right in there. I could have made this one piece. The only problem is that the case, where it splits in the middle, it's lifted on one side and the decal wasn't seating properly, so I ended up cutting it up and making two pieces. Just in case you're wondering, here's the second piece. There's my NX logo. Now, if you guys are wanting some custom stuff, if you really don't want my logo, I can replace it with something that you have. You have to submit your own work, and I'm willing to do custom stuff as long as the artwork belongs to you or has been licensed to you for reproduction. And we're moving on to do the shoulders of the radio. And basically right here I am talking about the antenna being in the way of the camera, but just line up the holes in the switch. There's two relief cuts just because of the way the decal folds over on both ends. And again, you can basically place one and then shift the other one over as you please. The decal is very forgiving that way. And you can just line it up. So I've made basically a piece for everything except the actual antenna itself. And then once I add heat, you'll see that it'll get rid of anything that like this section here that I'm trying to put down. The heat will just bring that piece down, right down. So it's not seating well. And then once I add the heat there, it'll just come right down. The decal pretty much just folds right over on its own. So I'm just pointing there that I'm gonna hit that with some heat later on. This section here, it all folds in nicely into this section here, and I've made enough relief cuts so that it just folds right over and you can just press it down. You can get your finger in there, but not so much in the corner, so you will have to use the pick to push it down a little bit. Once you get to the tighter corners, the heat will basically help get those corners down. If they become stubborn, you might be able to use a razor blade just to give a little bit more relief. Sometimes, just from misalignment, you might encounter some where the decal might need a little more folding than it actually needs. Don't forget about these two little pieces that go here in these corners, where the FR sky is located, and there's another one here on the left. Now, yeah, I grabbed it kind of goofy, so. All right, now we got that one section in. I'm explaining that the pattern is, because the pattern is abstract, it doesn't really matter how these small little pieces come in as long as they're somewhat the same color. It's practically impossible to line some of this stuff up because they're such small pieces and it's just so much time that's needed to adjust them properly. And just because they fold over so weird, it's almost impossible to get them to get them like 100% matching. That's why I like abstract, and you can barely notice the problem, the fit. So removing the other piece, you take it off gentle, put it over the switch, you can push down one side and then the other. You can pretty much just line up with your thumb once you like it. Just start pushing it down a little bit. I'm a little bit off camera here. And there you go. Pretty good fit. Just check over the sections that you might have missed. Use your pick there to bring the corners down. This is a really bad habit for me. I highly recommend not using really sharp picks on here. This is just me doing this probably hundreds of times, so I actually don't scratch my radio up. I do on occasion. If it's mine, I'm a little bit more reckless. But again, like, it's totally up to you whether you want to use a pick in the sharp side as well. So here's the backside on the old Taranis radio. I did not do the backside just because the front was so difficult to deal with, and it was just so much work that I just didn't have enough time to even consider doing the back, and not too many people cared for it. Now with the new radio and the shape of it, it's a little bit easier to do the front and the rear, so I basically chose to do both. The section on the switch is textured, and like I was saying before, the old decal just didn't really like the textured plastic. It's a little difficult to put on, so I switched medium, and I found the right combination. So again, pull out your cutouts, and you can start using heat to basically get all those corners down. Here I basically pulled that one section off and then realized that I should bring the corners down. And again, using the pick, use the back side, the blunt side. It's much safer that way. And you can use a credit card, you can use a debit card, the edge, nice soft plastic. This section here, because I added some heat, I'm just basically making sure that it's gonna seat down. And you don't have to sit here and push it down that hard. It really depends how much heat you put on. And if the corner's giving you a little bit of grief, maybe you put it on, you might have put the decal on crooked and you found out that you did that at the end of the run. Don't sweat it, just cut a little relief with an X-Acto blade, and you should be good to go. But as you can see, I didn't even bother cutting. Now we're checking the other side, making sure it's all down. And once you are happy the way the decal is, then we'll move on to putting on the switch part. So this one's pretty much a guess of where, like, it'll line up with the corner. It doesn't have to be perfect. As you can see here, I'm just lining it up and just give it a couple of tries until you're happy with it. Line it up with the top piece, and you can see me pointing right there. And then this side here, it's gonna be just a little long, and you can just basically push the corner down, and with the heat, that shouldn't be an issue. And I made relief cuts in there so that it basically wraps right over. And if you happen to be not aligned, just pull it back a little bit, realign it to where you're happy. Put a little bit of heat. Don't go too crazy, don't burn yourself. When you put your heat gun down, make sure you put it in an area that you're not going to brush up against it, because that really hurts. And I'm not responsible for you guys burning yourselves. or burning down your house because you put it against something that was flammable. So just a little word of caution right there. So we got the one side there, and we're gonna put the top on with the double switch holes. And I've made this pretty tight fit. Well, not a tight fit, but a fairly good fit that you shouldn't have any troubles lining it up. Just gently unline once you're happy with that, and push it down with your thumb. Bottom piece in, and this is the rough area. This is the textured plastic. So once you add the heat, you'll see how easy it'll just fold over for you. And basically here I'm just telling you that don't burn your hand. So I've added some heat and pressing down the corners before I put the other piece on, just like the left side. And again, just put one side down. My big hand is kind of in the way. Put it down, give it a quick look, and you can move the corner out if you need to. Blunt side of your pick. This section here, just the way I put it on, the this section, you can, it's your call. You can basically use heat and it should come down, or if you're not, you know, you're worried that it's gonna lift, you can just make a small incision with a your X-Acto. And here I pick up my X-Acto and I'm basically talking about it, saying that it's an optional. If you feel that it needs to be cut, you can give it a cut, and the cut shouldn't be more than 2 mils, maybe max, if you were to cut it. But I believe I do not use I don't use the X-Acto. Just add it to me. And as you can see, my heat gun is also three to four inches away from the radio, and I don't hold it in one spot for very long. And as you can see there, that piece went down no problem. Checking it, and this is where I say, you know, need to cut it and just give it a flick up, and that should be it. It's like a mil to 2 mils, and you can push it back down again. And this is all really just based on where you place the decal. I mean, I could have just pulled the decal away, and I could have pulled it back a little bit, but I'm just showing that it can still be put on without worrying about too much about alignment. So you know, for some of you guys that are not picky, and the fit is there for you guys that want to really, you know, some of you guys that really got that OCD, it's the fit's there. I mean, I've spent several hours trying to make everything everything fit as close as possible. And just checking corners. So basically, this is the main install. The big scary part was the big piece. As long as you take your time with it, remove it off the wax paper, and you're not rushing around, then the install is pretty straightforward. And we're gonna get to the back side here. Gonna use a little bit more heat just to make sure that everything's down. See, in these areas here, you can just come back to them at the very end, so you don't even have to worry about them when you first initially put them on. So you can see me putting pressure down with my thumb, putting a little bit of heat on, and you can see the texture actually in the glare of the light. And again, I'm not putting tons of heat on, very small bursts of heat, and just make sure you get your corners. You should be able to just rub it down with one finger. Corners right there are usually the hardest ones to put down, and with just a little bit of heat and a little bit of pressing down, they're pretty much not an issue. Make sure you take your time. So this is the top piece of the radio. It just goes around. I even put the little pieces on the corner, very small pieces. This is totally for you guys that have the OCD that want to put them in there. You don't have to put them in there, but no. I went the extra mile just to make sure for some of you guys that wanted to do the whole thing. There it is. This real skinny piece, so just make sure you don't pull on it too hard. And then to the backside. For the backside, some of you guys that want customized radios, for a couple extra bucks, I can probably put a bunch of personal artwork that you want to put on there. And just be careful you don't pull and stretch the material. Otherwise, it'll fit like pretty much bang on. If you did pull on it a little bit, you can basically rest it. And if it seems like the decal doesn't want to go down, do not force it down. Just let it rest. Once you've set most of the decal down and you've aligned it, you can just add a little bit of heat in the area that's raised, that got stretched. And what will happen is when you add the heat, the decal will basically relax itself from the previous stretching. And it could be totally accidental, because the side pieces where the battery goes, they're quite skinny and they're easy to stretch, so even just pulling it off the wax paper could do that. And in here, I had a decent fit, and then I realized that the bottom had a bit of a gap, so I basically took it off, repositioned it. So you can see that I just cut there. So I basically already dealt with the bubble, and you can kind of see it right there. Put a little bit of heat on it and just lightly dab it. And your bubble is gone just like that. It's like you just wipe it off. So not an issue. So this is a great place to put logos. Battery compartment's also been cut where the ribs are. I can't honestly remember what I was talking about, but I think I was talking about the bubble that I fixed. And worst case scenario, I'm basically telling you that you can, because it's raised, you can just flick your razor cut upwards and then just overlap them if it's really bad. But I prefer the other method. And here I'm taking out my last piece. Is this my last piece? Yeah. So this wrap here is way better than the older Tyrannus. Just because it's a lot less items, less work. The average person is probably going to take anywhere from 45 minutes to maybe an hour, and the big chunk of that is probably just going to be removing the unwanted decals, or the unwanted excess material. Some people want to just weed out the entire sheet first, which is not a bad idea. Or you just weed them out as you go, but it's nice not to have them in the way when you're actually placing down the decal. So here I am looking at the decal, or the install. I noticed that I missed the spot there, so I'm going to fix that with my pick. And I'm using the blunt edge again. So at first when you put this on, it might look like, oh geez, this guy didn't get it right. It's all pre-planned. So you just got yourself a nice snug fit all the way around there. Just add a little bit more heat. Get those corners. And this is just excess decal material where I split the one piece into two. That concludes our install. Check out nxgraphics.ca, and thank you for watching.